The stock which is currently on our radar is Bharti Infratel. The company has reported subdued revenues. Revenues were flat on a quarter-on-quarter basis, but there was a beat on the margins as well as profitability, which is why that stock is higher by 5%. Akhil Gupta, the managing director of the company, now joins in. Good afternoon, Mr. Gupta. Thanks for joining in. First, can you walk us through the key reason for flat revenues this quarter? Because historically, your revenues used to go up by 2 to 3% sequentially.
Well, if you look at our revenue line, we have the sharing revenue and we have energy revenue. And so, as you know, the diesel prices did come down quite sharply in the last couple of quarters. And as per our agreement with our customers, that saving is passed on. Therefore, the revenue from energy is lower. And that's why on the overall front, you do see a flat revenue line. But if you look at the sharing revenue, it has been increasing steadily.
Fair enough. And that's probably because of the tenancy revenues. That's up 7th straight quarter, Mr. Gupta. Will this continue to rise, tenancy revenues? And what would be the target rate on tenancy by the end of the current year?
Well, we don't give guidance, so I can't give you any exact estimate. But yeah, I think from what we are seeing, the tenancy factor or the sharing factor should grow steadily over the next year as well.
Okay. You know, the company has been talking about improving the capital structure by doing a buyback, various acquisitions. However, so far there's been no progress on that. What's the key reason and how is the company planning to improve the capital structure?
Well, the first piece which we have done is, of course, you would have seen the dividend, which is 6.50 rupees per share as the final dividend, taking it to 11 rupees for the full year. Along with the dividend distribution tax, that means roughly about 91%. Of the net profit, over 90% net profit has been distributed. On the buyback, well, we haven't got any clarification from the Ministry of Corporate Affairs on some clarity in respect of a provision of the Companies Act, which we will pursue, but till we get that, we cannot go ahead with any return of capital.
Okay. What about tower acquisitions? We were given to understand the company is interested in acquiring towers both in the domestic and international markets.
Well, nothing on the horizon at this point. We do remain interested. We do look at any possibility. But unfortunately, I have nothing on the horizon at this point. But we will certainly keep looking at any good opportunity that comes our way.
Okay, when we spoke to you last time, you indicated that the company's target is to bring your net debt to EBITDA to 2x. However, that time you didn't give us any timeline. Has the company now set a timeline?
I can't set the timeline in the absence of a clarity from either Ministry of Corporate Affairs or some big acquisition opportunities coming our way. So, at this point, unfortunately, no timeline for that.
Yeah, Mr. Gupta, may I flip back to the acquisition questions? You had spoken about acquiring towers in Bangladesh. Any other towers that the company is interested in acquiring?
Well, we did mention about Bangladesh for sure, and that does remain of great interest. But there are some regulatory issues which we are in touch with the regulator there. Once those are sorted out, then only that acquisition can be considered.
Okay. So no other assets, I mean tower acquisitions that the company is interested in except in Bangladesh?
Well, we would be interested in several other assets, but nothing on the horizon at this point of time.
Actually, your tower addition has been quite robust at 828 versus 761 the previous year. How many towers do you want to add in FY16?
I don't know. We don't make towers prospectively. And therefore, it's difficult to give out an exact figure. It depends on the orders which we get from the operators. But I do expect that looking at the rollout which operators would be planning, I do expect that figure to increase. But the main thing is it's very modular. We are always prepared. Whatever is the demand, we are in a good position to cater to it.
Okay. You know, your earlier answer, you indicated that you expect steady improvement in your tenancy. It currently stands at 2.12. Do you think the tenancy could rise to 3x in the next 2 years?
No comments on that. It's too steep a target. I really don't think it can grow that fast. But in any case, as I said, we don't give guidance.
Fair point, Mr. Gupta. Thank you very much for joining us with those candid comments, actually.